motherboardsource.net.
Hello everyone, welcome to the channel. This is just a quick guide for anyone who's changed CMS support in their BIOS and now the BIOS option doesn't appear. So basically, just like the video here, you've made the change and you go to boot your computer hoping to press delete to load into the BIOS, and it either just sits on a black screen forever, or just like here, it will just load straight into Windows and give you no options. So it is a little bit of an annoying one. I don't know why Gigabyte and the other motherboard manufacturers haven't fixed the problem yet, but there's a few solutions, so bear with me. The first and quickest and easiest option is to switch from DisplayPort if you're using DisplayPort to HDMI. So unplug all your DisplayPort cables and just connect directly to a HDMI cable, and try to use one monitor if you can. Once you've done that, restart your computer and you should have the option to press delete and load into the BIOS. Now, if that doesn't work, you've got a couple more options. So the next option is to repeat the process with a HDMI cable, but plug it directly into your motherboard instead of your graphics card, if you have onboard graphics. Okay, so the next option, if that hasn't worked for you, is to remove the CMOS battery. So depending on your system, you're probably gonna have to remove your graphics card to get access to it. So I'm just gonna show you on an old motherboard I have here what the actual situation is. So usually the CMOS battery is behind the GPU, so you'll see it just here. Just flick the little kind of a lever thingy and the battery will pop out. Now leave it out for about a minute. Once you've done this, put it back in, put your motherboard back in, then connect using the HDMI cable, and you should be able to go back in, press delete and load the BIOS. It'll stop going back to the black screen. Now, alternatively, you can repeat this exact process and not use your graphics card and just use the onboard graphics. So I know it's a lot of messing around, and even once you've installed Windows 11 and everything's working fine, you've still got to have that CMS support disabled, which means you're not going to get access to the BIOS, which means you have to do this every time you want to go into the BIOS. It's a total nightmare. The manufacturers need to update their BIOS and solve the problem. I don't know why they haven't, it's been going on for a while. Secondly, if you're trying to clean install Windows and you're getting an error relating to a disk number missing, you can't assign a drive letter to whatever drive when you're trying to install Windows 11, just remove any of the other drives you have connected and try to leave just the primary drive you're installing Windows onto. If you can't do this, I'll leave a link in the description for an alternative method that'll allow you to manually assign a letter to the drive. So it basically is a command prompt, but it's easier if you just check out the guide because I can't actually demonstrate it at the moment. Anyway, I hope that fixes the problem with the black screen not loading, the BIOS and CMS support being the cause. So if you have found that helpful, don't forget to like and subscribe, and if you've found any other solutions for this, don't forget to drop them in the comments. As always, thanks for watching, see you next time.